everybody, welcome to Storytime with Miss Sue. I have a book to share with you today called It's Always About Nate. We read a story about a boy named Nate who had something called hemophilia. Well, this is a story about that same boy, but it's kind of more about his sisters. So let's read. Tuesday felt like a very long day for 6-year-old Chloe Brown. She didn't mind school, but riding the bus home was always long and boring. But tonight was going to be different. It was the dress rehearsal for Chloe's first dance recital. She was nervous and excited. Nate, who was almost 9 years old, sat behind Chloe with his best friend, Nick. Chloe sat 2 seats ahead chatting with her good friend and Nick's sister, Rose. I can hardly wait for the recital, Chloe told Rose. Tonight we get to wear our costumes when we practice. It's going to be great. The bus driver stopped at the bus stop by the neighborhood playground as usual, but Nate and Chloe's mom's car was not there yet. Rose and Nick's mom, Mrs. Gomez, greeted the kids as they got off the bus. I'll wait with Nate and Chloe until Mrs. Bowen gets here, said Mrs. Gomez, the bus driver. She must be running late. Chloe and Rose ran to the swings to play. Nate and Nick decided to go throw rocks in the pond. Hey guys, yelled Miss Gomez from the parking lot. Be careful not to fall into the pond. We won't, shouted Nate and Nick at the same time. As Mrs. Bowen drove into the parking lot, Chloe and Rose ran to meet her. Thank you so much for waiting with the kids, Mrs. Bowen told Mrs. Gomez. I got stuck in traffic coming home from the grocery store. When Mr. Bowen is out of town on business, it seems there are not enough hours in the day to get everything done. No problem, said Mrs. Gomez. I think they all needed a bit of time to run around after the bus ride. Just as Mrs. Bone was about to ask where Nate was, she heard a loud scream come from the pond area. Both mothers ran down to see what had happened while Nick came running up to them. What happened, Nick? Where's Nate? Mrs. Bowen shouted, trying to stay calm. He fell and hit his head on a rock, said Nick, out of breath. As soon as Mrs. Bowen got to Nate, he was sobbing and holding his head in his hands. Mom, I accidentally slipped and fell on this rock. My head really hurts. He wailed, rocking back and forth. Okay, Nate, hold on and be still. Let's get you home and infuse factor and put some ice on the bump, Nate's mom instructed, trying to be as calm as possible. Driving down the road, Mrs. Bowen said in a soothing yet commanding voice, Okay, guys, the first thing we have to do is stop home to give Nate an infusion, then we need to go to the hospital. Oh, Mom, whined Chloe from the back seat. I can't go to the hospital tonight. It's my dress rehearsal for my recital. I don't want to miss it. Chloe, her mother replied, still in control, we have to get Nate to the hospital to get a CT scan to make sure his head is okay. I'll call your dance teacher from the car. As they coasted into the driveway, Mrs. Bowen gave directions. Nate, go directly to the couch and lie down. Chloe, you go grab the hospital bag that's in the front closet and get an ice pack from the freezer. Mrs. Bowen headed upstairs to mix the factor and put several more doses and supplies in the bag that Chloe brought her. She set up the infusion station they created in the family room where Nate was already laying down. Once Nate was infused, Mrs. Bowen began to get ready to go to the hospital. Katie, Mrs. Bowen yelled upstairs to her oldest daughter, I need you to get ready to go to the hospital. What did you say, Mom? Katie shouted, coming out of her room, pulling her earbuds out. Nate just got hurt at the park and we have to take him to the hospital. Again? Katie asked, exasperated. That kid is always getting hurt. I can't go to the hospital. I have a game to cheer at tonight. Now, Katie, replied Mom firmly. This is very serious. Nate fell and hit his head, and you know how serious a head bleed can be. It wouldn't hurt for you to be a bit more compassionate for others, you know. And yes, you have to go with us. I don't know how long we'll be, and someone needs to stay with Chloe in the waiting room. Take your uniform with you, and if we get out of the hospital soon enough, I'll take you to the game. Katie reluctantly followed her mother out to the car. Here we go again, Chloe said to Katie. I have to miss my dress rehearsal tonight. It isn't fair that we have to go. Katie put her finger over her lips and said, Chloe, be quiet. Mom might hear you. You're just missing practice. I'm supposed to cheer at the game tonight. Now I have to miss it. I don't even know why I bothered to bring my uniform along. Girls, let's go. Please, now, said their mother from the car. Mrs. Bone called her husband, who was out of town, and explained what had happened. Did you infuse before you left? Asked Mr. Bowen, very concerned. Yes, the girls helped me with that. Now we're off to the hospital, answered Mrs. Bowen. Okay, let me talk to the big guy, said Nate's dad. Hey, Dad, Nate sniffed. Heard you had a bit of a tumble at the park today, buddy, Mr. Bowen said. Yeah, Dad, my head really hurts bad. It was just an accident, Dad. Nate was crying a bit now. I know, Nate, don't worry. They'll take good care of you at the hospital. It'll be okay, Nate's dad said reassuringly. He was very concerned, but was hiding it from Nate. Be brave, like you always are, and keep your sisters out of trouble over there, okay? Joked Mr. Bowen. We heard that, Dad, Katie and Chloe shouted out loud at the same time. Keep me posted. Call me when you get home, said their dad. When they arrived at the emergency section of the hospital, Mrs. Bowen checked in at the desk while the girls went to the waiting room. Always about Nate, said Katie. All our stuff always takes second to Nate. Just because he's a klutz, I have to miss the game. Well, this is my dress rehearsal for my dance recital. How am I going to know what to do tomorrow? Chloe said with tears in her eyes. Nate's favorite hematologist, Dr. G, walked into the room. Hey, Nate, what are you doing here? The doctor said with a big grin. I accidentally fell on a rock at the park, replied Nate, still holding the ice pack to the back of his head. Ouch, that's not good, buddy, Dr. G said, examining the cold bump just under his hair. Let's get a CT scan and make sure your big noggin is all right. Is that okay with you, bud? Yeah, I guess, said Nate, a bit worried now. Dr. G motioned to Mrs. Bowen to join him in the hallway. Did you happen to see the accident? Asked the doctor. No, the boys were down by the pond, she said. Did the fall knock him out? No, he was alert when I got there. When did Nate get infused last? That is an important step in making sure there is no bleeding into his brain. It's what we refer to as intracranial hemorrhage. Well, he got his regular treatment yesterday morning, and I infused him again right before we came here this afternoon. You did the right thing by infusing him before you came in. Has he been acting any differently since he fell? I mean, has he been sick to his stomach, dizzy? Or when looking at his eyes, is one pupil larger than the other? These are some signs of an intracranial hemorrhage. No, he's been acting normally. Let's see what the CT scan says, so we'll be sure, replied Doc G, escorting Nate and Mrs. Bowen to the exam room. Katie and Clodie overheard the conversation between Mom and Doc G. Is Nate going to be all right? Chloe asked Katie. We'll have to wait and see, said Katie. Doctor is the best around. He'll take care of Nate. Chloe hung her head down. What's wrong, Chloe? Nate's going to be just fine. Chloe buried her head in Katie's shoulder and began to cry. It's going to be okay. Why are you crying?
Sometimes I get so angry when we have to drop everything we are doing when Nate gets hurt, replied Chloe quickly. And Mom and Dad treat him differently. Like when Nate was little, he would have tantrums when it was time to get infused. He just didn't want to get stuck with the needle. Mom and Dad bribed him a toy so he would sit still when they pushed the factor into his vein.
Katie decided to challenge her sister. Chloe, remember when we both had to get stuck with a needle when the nurse drew blood to check our factor levels and see if we were carriers of the genetic disorder? Remember how much it hurt? We talked about how bad we felt for Nate because he had to get stuck 3 times a week, said Katie.
Yeah, I guess I forgot about that day, replied Chloe. But there was the time when he got to watch TV and play video games all day because he had a bad knee bleed and needed to stay off his feet. Mom and Dad never let me do that. They say they try to even it out, but it never really seems that we get the special treatment he gets just because he has hemophilia.
Chloe, you got to watch cartoons all weekend when you had your tonsils out. You got all the ice cream you wanted while Nate and I had to clean the house, reminded Katie.
Oh, yeah, said Katie, remembering.
Chloe thought about how for many years they had been going to community events to listen to speakers talk about all kinds of things related to hemophilia and had even participated in workshops for kids. They, like Nate, had made some good friends over the years and often look forward to certain events too, but they complained about going just the same. Katie interrupted Chloe's thoughts. Remember the time when Grandma had to fly to our house to stay with us because Mom and Dad had to be in the hospital with Nate when he had to have that port infection? The infection would not go away. They ended up having to do surgery to remove that port and put a whole new one on the other side of his chest. He had to stay in the hospital so long. I felt so bad for Nate. He had to miss the last 2 weeks of school, and he even missed the first swim meet of the season. I was really worried about him that time. And do you remember the time when Nate fell off the monkey bars at the park and landed on his head, chimed in Chloe. We all went to the emergency room to see if he was going to be okay. He had to have a CT scan that time, too. Want to know a secret? I was really worried about him that day, too, said Katie. I was glad when he got back to his old self the next day and began bugging me again. Katie and Chloe smiled at each other. Sometimes I completely forget that Nate ever even has hemophilia. Since he is in prophylaxis and gets factor at home, he can do just about anything he wants to without getting a bleed. Those are the times when everything seems normal, Katie said. But I can always tell when something serious has happened to Nate. Mom and Dad get this really concerned look of panic on their face and try to hide it from us. Sometimes I worry during those times, but Nate's tough guy attitude always pulls him through, reminding me once again that he is my very annoying little brother. Oh, he can be so annoying sometimes, added Chloe. Suddenly, Nate and his mother joined everyone in the waiting room. So, what happened to you, Nate? Asked Chloe. Did you have to have a CT scan? Yeah, but it was no big deal, said Nate. I just laid still and watched all the lights in the machine. It was kind of cool. The doctor said my head is still full of brains. I'm just fine. You guys worry about every little thing. You are so annoying, but I'm glad you're okay, said Katie. Oh, you're here, Mrs. Anderson. Thank goodness, said Mrs. Bowen, as their neighbor walked into the waiting room. Chloe, Mrs. Anderson is going to take you to class dress rehearsal. Katie, I'm going to drop you off at the gym for your game on your way home. And as for you, Nate, you are on the sofa for the rest of the night. Oh, Mom, I feel fine. I want to go to the game, too, said Nate. You get home and rest up, said Katie. Enjoy having the remote all to yourself. Yeah, added Chloe, smiling, because tomorrow the special treatment is over. Sometimes it's hard to have a brother or sister who's sick and gets lots of attention because of that, isn't it? But Katie and Chloe seem to understand why that was important. I hope if you have a brother or sister who has a lot of sickness or treatments that you talk to your mom and dad about how you feel. Thanks for sharing this book with me.